Arlena, Max here, EHPlabs, over here at Biomechanix for a quick active recovery workout with Arlena. I'll introduce her real quick. Let's go inside and get it in.
I got my BM BCAA. I'm gonna sip on it during the workout. Had some OxyShred in the morning on an empty stomach. I'm staying shredded year round. If you haven't tried OxyShred, visit our website, www.ehplabs.com. Or ask for any nearby retailer. Attack the stubborn fat cells with OxyShred. The best thermogenic fat burner on the market.
How you doing?
How are you? Hey everybody, this is Arlena. She's gonna guide us through a quick active recovery workout. But first I'm gonna get on the treadmill and get our heart rate up. Get
a little warm up.
A little warm up before the action.
So what we're going to do today is a little active recovery upper body work. Nothing too crazy. We train all week, so we do a little light work today. We're going to do a little arms, back, shoulders, normal. A little bit of everything. So this is just a basic bicep curl with a straight bar. Cables. My arms are small right now. Don't make fun of them.
Nah, they look pretty good to me.
So whole point in. And really anything when you're working out is slow movements. You don't need to rush through them. You don't need to do this. This doesn't do anything. So you gotta go nice and slow, especially on that release. You can push down on the weight as you're releasing. Push down on the weight. So as you release, so it gives you even better negative. So if you have a training partner to help you do this. And then overhead here could be another one. So if you want to make that
accessory, it's all bicep. So, close.
Outside.
There you go.
Different, right?
Yeah, it is different. I'm just getting started.
And
reverse.
To the top.
How high do I go up?
All the way up. Squeeze to the top and let it down. Whoa. Squeeze to the top. Anytime you're doing a bicep curl, I always try to squeeze to the top and let it down. About these is you can do them a couple different ways. You can let it all the way down and hold at the bottom. That's a nice little teaser workout for your triceps to hold. And so when you extend at the bottom, focus on pulling the rope apart. So that can really work that tricep muscle. A little pulsing at the end will really bring out that muscle. So right in between, not all the way up, not all the way down, just stop right there. Yep. There you go. Feel that burn? One of my favorites for shoulder band, your side laterals at the same time.
That must be engaging the core too, because you're like...
Exactly. So you're working really a lot of upper body in this exercise here. It could be a high rep exercise, so you're hitting 20. Straight out, straight front. Here.
Oh, you're not messing around. I thought it was active recovery.
We do 10 and 10. When you're done, go for it.
Okay, so guide me through this. I'll start.
So you start one front, one side. And one front. Put you down nice and smooth. Right to the side. A little coordination.
There you go. Like, I actually have to use my brain cells.
Try to keep those arms nice and straight.
Not bent.
That's correct. Perfect arm. Get a nice burn all the way through the shoulder. It's going to be nice and parallel to the floor. Arms are nice and parallel. Come out to a press. Keep those elbows parallel to the floor. So arms are parallel to the ground always. You don't let them drop here. You're here.
And this is crazy.
Keep the weights nice and straight. Focus. Up straight, arms go up all the way straight, all the way straight, boom, all the way up, press, up, press, what is that? That's a half foot press, press all the way, straight arm, there you go.
Those burn.
That's good.
I usually don't go all the way up because I have pretty strong triceps. So I don't go all the way up to avoid using triceps, so it's like...
A regular person,
go all the way up, but the movement has to be customized to your body type.
For this guy,
it looks like I'm cheating, but I'm not. Trust me.
Since you already have dumbbells, this is an easy one for rear delts. So we've already hit front, we've hit side. So rear delts are bent over here. So make sure on this one, back is flat. Chest is up, shoulders are down. Another one is weights are out. You go here like you're pouring coffee. Harder. Not as easy.
This one's a harder variation.
Harder variation, a little bit more advanced, a little bit more resistance because of the way the chest is up.
Higher.
Back. Try not to rock it too much as you come up to get straight. Nice and stiff. Get that back and arm to bring you up back. There you go. Your bend over here. All the way back. Engaging those rear delts. Use that back.
Yeah. Get my butt kicked.
So on this one, form's tricky. Shoulders gotta stay down, elbows gotta stay wide. Focus on pulling the rope apart so that you can use your back. Straight to the forehead. Can be a set of 10, let's just say.
You're hitting
your delts. Back. Your next one would be to the neck. It's a little bit different muscle group in the back. Chest stays up, shoulders stay down. And then really hit those lats and back as you do this.
Like three different variations. Can I get some? Yeah. She's being greedy. Got me on the form. I don't do these at all.
So form. Chest up. Chest up. I like to put one foot in front of the other. All the way to your forehead. Pull it apart. There you go. All the way back.
You good?
Yep. Chest up, forward.
There you go. Is that way, coach?
Yep, and keep your head back. You don't need to put your head in it. It just goes here. And then straight to the neck here. Yep, right here. Okay.
Oh! Okay, so I don't do this exercise normally. It's great that Arlena is here making me do them. Being challenged in a different way, not going super heavy, still getting a great workout. So I challenge you to try new exercises because your body can adapt to the same ones.
So this one's more. Even more challenging. You gotta pull it all the way apart, like you're pulling it around your arm. So this one's really,
this feels
really
great.
Yeah. All the way back to your rib cage. All the way back, pull it apart, pull it apart. Focus on pulling it apart. There you go, pull it apart, pull it apart. Stretch your rib cage. Keep that chest up, shoulders down. Form is very important on this one. Such
wow.
A difficult exercise. Right? Even hit your lats a little.
That feels very effective.
Elbows are flat, down, eyes to the sky. So you're not doing this when you're doing crunches. That's so important. When I teach my classes, I do that all the time.
Okay.
People doing this. You don't,
like
it's not a neck exercise. Right. It's an ab exercise. So focus on rolling forward. Shoulders are rolling up and down because of your abs, not because of your neck. So we're riding some bicycles here. Hit those obliques.
Oh yeah,
make
like
sure
these. Yeah.
Bicycles.
Yeah, these feel great.
Twist those obliques, grind into it, roll those shoulders on the mat.
Oh yeah, more. Let's do this.
Another one I like, leg lifts. Hands going to booty. Here. So with leg lifts, feet are flexed towards you. So that means your toes are flexed towards you. The farther back you go towards you when you're lifting, the less work you're getting in your abs. Another one is, raise it all the way up. Let it down slow. Again, that negative release really burns out those abs. And then a lower leg lift here to burn out is nice too. You can't tell I really work out my abs. Sometimes I do. Feel nice and tight and pretty for our bikinis and
bikini
shorts. I gave him a bikini last week. He just won't put it on yet.
Yeah, they don't have sizes that fit me.
Simple bicep curls. Here. Slow release. I like to count 3 to 4 seconds on the way down. It gives it a nice burn, so you don't have to do as many reps.
Are you getting a combination of toning and lean muscle building with these?
Exactly. You can reverse it into some hammer curls. Important thing with hammer curls is, don't do this. This doesn't do anything. I'm a big believer in strict form, why it works. So you're here. Squeeze at the top.
Looks like your endurance stamina is pretty good.
Cardio. I do a lot of Stairmaster. Most efficient way to burn a lot of calories.
Stairmaster.
In a short amount of time. Also work your legs, your booty, your glutes, your hamstrings, calves. So work all your legs. I also incorporate bands sometimes. So I'll wrap around a band right around here around my knees and you walk.
How long are your cardio sessions?
20 to 30 minutes, about 4 to 5 days a week. That's about all I do. That's a maintenance type of routine. If you're really trying to burn fat or lose weight, get out of cardio. Especially if you're trying to lose weight here in your belly fat area. You need to really cardio, make sure you're eating right. We talked about diet last time.
Yes.
So important. Max and I were down in our chicken and our egg whites, whatever it
is.
Before we work out, make sure we're fueled.
If you're not fueled, you can't train hard.
You're not getting anything out of your workout. So if you're going to work at the gym at a, on an empty stomach, it's not going to do anything for you. So eat.
Do not sacrifice diet.
Before, eat after, eat good food. No cheeseburgers, even though we love cheeseburgers.
You can have your cheat meals, but just make sure you know you got your priorities straight. What's next?
Chest is up.
Definitely want to do that.
Shoulders are down.
One of my favorite back exercises, lat pull down.
The hardest one of them all. And reverse. So again. Straight down left. All the way down. Right to the top of your chest.
If I go any lower, I eat biceps.
Okay.
I remember my mom doing much longer.
I know, right?
Look at those traps.
That's an accident.
That is consistency. What you're seeing is a result of a positive, healthy lifestyle.
Every day.
Today is freestyle. Like I said, we train all week. I just wanted to show you guys some active recovery supersets you can incorporate at the end of the week. Thanks for joining us today.